Hi guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make some abstract art. Okay, the first thing you need to do is get yourself some cardstock or some comic board paper. Alright, next thing you need to do is you need to get yourself some markers that are like ink based, where it's like the spectrum. They're pretty good. They have two different tips. They have the thin tip, and then you have that. Now these are alcohol markers. You could probably get away with using like some watercolor markers, but I'm not really sure how they will blend. Alright, so for the first one, I'm going to do is something a little different. I'm going to take the thin side of the marker, and I'm just going to go ahead and do an outline. Okay, kind of resembles a face a little bit. Then after that, I'm just going to kind of go down. And just keep coloring the different lines. You want to go through and do this with various colors. Okay, now once you have that done, you can let it dry. Okay, so you can leave it like this, or you can take some 100% acetone nail polish remover, and you can kind of blend it together just a little bit more than it already is. It's completely up to you. I personally like it before the blend. But it'll just give it more of a painted look this way, because you won't see marker lines. So it's up to you which way you like it the most. And if you just keep going different directions, it'll make it look like it's canvas. So I went this way, and now I'm going the opposite way. And if you notice, if you can see it, it actually resembles the zigzag crisscross lines that a canvas might have. But you also lose the vibrance in your color. Okay, so now for another one, now when you're using the comic book paper, one side shiny, one side flat, I forgot to tell you, you want to make sure you're doing it with the flat side, because otherwise it just will not look right at all. Okay, so for this one, we're just going to kind of use this as a thing to trace it. Okay, so I just basically made a bunch of circles on this paper, and now what I want to do is I want to go back in and I want to use some of my colors, and I want to color in between. I'll be honest with you, I don't like doing the yellow because it picks up all of the lines, even if you barely touch it. It grabs a little bit of it, so your yellow is never quite vibrant. So you might want to keep that in mind when you're doing your project. So just be careful about that. Okay, so you just want to continue this process throughout the entire photo or drawing. Okay, so let's finish it up with this purple again. Don't really like this, so I'm gonna go over it with a darker color. I just don't like how it captured that black. And then that's how you would do this one. Okay, so in order to do this one here, what I did is I took a black Sharpie and a silver Sharpie. Now you can tape them together if you like, or you can just hold them together. And then just run it out to get the ink off of where they might have overlapped. Now, because it has a lot of silver and I want a little bit more black on there, I'm going to kind of go back over by itself. And then there's that one. Basically, it just looks like a giant scribble. Now, for something like this, what I did is I took the markers and I took the flat end and I just went various locations. And then you want to take the thin side and then you just kind of want to do little swirls. And if you want to even take it one step further, you can take and put little tiny circles in there somewhere. Kind of looks like a birthday surprise. Okay, so another one with a circle is you can go like this. And then find whatever color you're going to use. I'm going to go with the purple. Just like that. Then you want to take something that has a straight edge. And just make some defining lines. And then just color them in. Okay, so for this one, what I'm doing is I'm taking a butterfly wing. Actually, it's really a mermaid tail that I glued together to make a butterfly. But anyway, I'm taking this and I'm going around. And I'm tracing it just like that. Okay, now I'm taking a milk lid. And I'm just making some half moon shapes right here. Now I'm just going to go over to the other corner and down here. And then I'm going to go up into the butterfly. And then continue that around. All right, so now I'm using this game piece and I'm going to draw a circle just around like that, and then one right here. And then I'm going to use the pen cap. Well, never mind, the pen cap's too big that way. Okay, I don't have anything small. So I'm going to freehand it. I'm going to draw a little circle there. and a little circle there. Okay, now we're going to color it in. Okay guys, so here's some art. Alright guys, so I hope this tutorial was helpful. Like and subscribe, leave a question, suggestion, or comment below, and I will see you next time. Click the bell to be notified. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.